Hey guys, this is Martin again from Series E, and today I want to talk to you about what makes an LED strip a high quality strip. There's a lot of different strips in the market. You know, you can find them on eBay, on the web. You know, they're everywhere, and there's all sorts of prices and even qualities and varieties of strip. But the question still remains, what makes a strip a high quality strip? It's not the color of the PCB board. It's not the color of the actual LEDs. It's not really how bright it is, although that is a contributing factor. But the main thing that makes a strip a high quality strip is actually the efficiency and the quality of the components that are used. For example, we carry two types of strip. We have the high quality RGB 5050 strip in both dual and single density, and then we also have the low cost RGB 5050 in dual and single density. Both of these models are both available in waterproof and non-waterproof versions, but today I'm going to be using a single density RGB 5050 high quality and a low cost ones just to compare. Right away, you'll notice that they're both different colors, okay? So the high quality, it's like this copper natural color, and the low cost, you'll see it's a white color. Like I said, the color doesn't define the strip, whether it's good quality or bad quality. But also what you could tell fairly easily is that this one kind of like looks a little bit flimsy. It's a little bit crumpled up as opposed to this one. It's more rigid, more straight. The reason for that is the thickness of the PCB board, how thick the copper is. The more copper you have, the more current could flow easier, making the strip more efficient, causing less resistance. It's kind of like having a water pipe. The thicker the pipe, the easier the water flows and the more efficient the pipe becomes. That's pretty much what's going on here. So that's the main difference here from the low cost and the high quality strip. And you'll notice that a lot of different strips that you may find, the PCB may not be as thick as it should be, causing it to be less efficient. So the high quality strip, this one right here, has about 2 millimeters thickness in the PCB board, as opposed to this one's like right under a millimeter. So that's a big contributing factor right there. The other thing is also the pureness of the copper used in the PCB board is what makes it more efficient as well. So the more pure the copper, the more efficient it will be as well, the less resistance it will cause. The next contributing factor is also the quality of the LED chips, okay? They may look the same, they're both 5050 RGB LED chips, but it all depends on the phosphor use and the quality of the component. So that also varies a lot. So like I said, the color doesn't say anything. The color also of the LED doesn't say anything when it's lighting up. And the brightness does indicate to a certain extent whether it's high quality or not, but it's not definitive. So that's pretty much the main differences here. Like I said, this is not really a technical video. I'm not going to be showing you any specs. I already have a video up that shows you the different specs that the strip's running in real time. So you could check that one out if you want to see the actual specs. But here I was just, you know, trying to let you guys know the different key features that makes the strip either high quality or not. So that's pretty much all I wanted to share with you guys. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. And if you guys have any questions and any comments, don't forget to drop us a comment there in the comment box. Also, don't forget to subscribe and check out our website at series-e.com. Thanks for watching.